What if I told you that somewhere in a dense, dark forest in America lurks a crumbling, 3-story, 16-room abandoned medieval castle whose owner was actually killed directly by a lightning strike? Or that high in the rugged mountains of New York State lie the lost ruins of an overgrown 19th century abandoned stone castle that was once used by the Freemasons? I didn't believe it either, at first. But then I decided to go check out these places for myself, and I was blown away. Today, we'll be exploring the top 5 creepiest abandoned castles in America. Number 5. Hearthstone Castle, Danbury, Connecticut. Hearthstone Castle was a 3-story, 16-room stone castle that was built between 1895 and 1899. The property is located near Danbury, Connecticut, and it includes 4 contributing structures as well as several other crumbling outbuildings spread out nearby. This once proud castle now lies forgotten and boarded up, home only to the weeds and the wildlife. First known as Sanford Castle, Hearthstone was designed by architect Ernest Dietrich for its first owner, E. Star Sanford, a noted portrait photographer who also invented an early movie camera. However, Sanford suffered a strange and tragic death. He was killed directly by a lightning strike, no less. After that, none of the castle's owners seemed to have been willing to keep the castle for more than a few years. They would always move out fairly soon after moving in. After going through several owners, the complex was eventually given its current name, Hearthstone Castle. The last residents of Hearthstone Castle were a Richard and Constant Jennings. The Jenningses lived there for only 4 years, from 1983 until 1987. Since they moved out, the structure has remained uninhabited, slowly but surely falling into disrepair. Eventually, the roof and several walls collapsed, adding even more to its sinister, disheveled appearance. The outbuildings, now also in ruins, include a caretaker's cottage, carriage house, barn, woodshed, and water tower, all clustered on higher ground to the south of the main building. Number 4. Elda Castle, Ossining, New York. Deep in the dark, dense forests of New York State hide the overgrown, crumbling ruins of a roughly century-old castle that belonged to one of the wealthiest and most successful men in America, David Abercrombie, co-founder of the famous clothing brand Abercrombie & Fitch. In 1927, Abercrombie built his own retreat, an estate on more than 300 acres he called Elda, named for the first initials of his 4 children, Elizabeth, Lucy, David, and Abbott. Tragically, soon after the castle was completed, Lucy died in an Ossining factory chemical fire in 1929, and the son David died in 1937 when kicked in the abdomen by a horse in Wyoming. Then, in 1937, David Abercrombie himself passed away from rheumatic fever, and soon afterwards, the castle was sold in the 1940s and eventually ended up abandoned. Several restoration attempts going back to 1964 have all failed, and today, the overgrown and crumbling remains of Elda Castle lie in ruins. Sadly, this ominous place is now all but forgotten, having become the source of all kinds of dark rumors and legends, possibly due to the constant death and tragedy that always seemed to befall whoever happened to own the property at the time. Number 3. Lake Worth Castle, Fort Worth, Texas. The Lake Worth Castle, also known as Old Heron Castle, is located near Fort Worth, Texas. A 1-story gabled rear wing is believed to be the original 3-room stone farmhouse that predates the rest of the castle, having reportedly been built on this site around the year 1860. Construction of the rest of this amazing dwelling began at some point during the 1920s, and it was completed around the year 1938. Legend tells that the owner and builder of the original structure found his betrothed floating dead in the lake. Her cause of death was never clear, but either way, the groom was curiously undeterred in his marriage plans, and he proceeded to wed her sister only a month later. Sometime after that, one of the sons of the castle's owner reportedly committed suicide inside the castle. Then, in 1939, the dwelling suffered from a serious fire, the cause of which is unknown. In the following years, every venture that took place here always seemed to lose steam, sooner or later, as owner after owner was driven bankrupt by this castle and its apparently never-ending misfortunes. After that, the castle stood alone and untouched for many years until recently, when it was purchased by new owners who reportedly planned to restore it. Number 2. Bannerman's Castle, Beacon, New York. The ruins of Bannerman's Castle are located on a 6.5-acre island in the Hudson River in New York State. The structure was originally constructed as a military surplus warehouse around the year 1901. Its story begins in November 1900, when a Francis Bannerman VI purchased the island for use as a storage facility for his growing military surplus business. Since his storeroom in New York City wasn't large enough to safely store 30 million surplus munitions cartridges, he began to build an arsenal on his private island in the spring of 1901. It was the perfect location for arms storage, as not only was this island isolated and uninhabited, but it was also even avoided by locals, given the fact that many, including the Native Americans in the Hudson Valley, considered the island to be cursed. Although most of the colossal stone castle was devoted to storing his volatile merchandise, Bannerman built another smaller structure on top of the island to use as a residence. The storehouse, clearly visible from the shore of the river, served as a giant advertisement for his business. On the side of the castle facing the western bank of the Hudson, Bannerman cast the legend Bannerman's Island Arsenal into the wall. Bannerman continued constructing and expanding the castle right up until his death in 1918. However, about 2 years later, 200 pounds of shells and powder exploded in a secondary structure, destroying a portion of the complex. Eventually, the island and buildings were bought by New York State in 1967, which took possession after the old military merchandise had been removed and the relics given to the Smithsonian. However, disaster struck again on the island on August 8th of 1969, when another mysterious fire devastated the arsenal, and the roofs and floors were burnt to a crisp. Number 1. Craggy Claire Castle, Roscoe, New York. The Craggy Claire Castle, also known as Dundas Castle, is an imposing, abandoned castle hidden away among the Catskill Mountains in upstate New York. Even today, a fair amount of mystery and intrigue surrounds the castle. To start off with, no one's really sure about when exactly it was constructed. What we do know is that the structure was originally a summer lodge built by a Bradford Lee Gilbert in the early 1880s. However, Gilbert died in 1911, and the land eventually came into the possession of Ralph Wirtz Dundas in 1915. Dundas began construction of the castle soon afterwards, but he never lived to see it completed, as he died in 1921 while the estate was in the final stages of construction. Then, in 1922, a year after Dundas's death, his wife, Josephine Wirtz Dundas, who had inherited the property, went insane and was committed to a sanatorium. After Anna's commitment, her only child by Dundas, Muriel Harmer Wirtz Dundas, inherited her mother's fortune. Eventually, however, Muriel's mental stability was questioned as well, and she was soon committed to a mental treatment facility, just as her mother had been. After a seemingly endless series of tragedies plagued the successive owners of this castle, one after another, the structure was repurposed several times over the years for various uses, all of which would also eventually end up failing. For a time, it was used as a summer camp for children, before being purchased by the area's Masonic chapter as a retreat. Although the Masons still own the structure, for one reason or another, they eventually ended up abandoning it as well, and it now sits there, neglected, crumbling, and ominously shrouded in perpetual fog and mystery. Thank you so much for joining me on this adventure. Please keep in mind that this isn't necessarily a list of all the abandoned castles in the United States, just the 5 creepiest ones in my opinion. Do you think I missed something? Please feel free to share your thoughts in the comments. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed the video and would like to explore along with me in my future adventures. I'll see you on the next one.